गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू लेसन, द विजयनगर एंड बहामनी किंगडम्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 हिस्ट्री। इन द अर्ली हाफ ऑफ द 14th सेंचुरी, ड्यू टू द डिसइंटीग्रेशन मीन्स ब्रेकिंग ऑफ द दिल्ली सल्तनत, अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ प्रोविंसेस बिकेम इंडिपेंडेंट बोथ इन द नॉर्थ एंड साउथ ऑफ इंडिया। प्रोविंसेस मीन्स एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिस्ट्रिक्ट और डिविजन ऑफ अ कंट्री। साउथ, विजयनगर किंगडम वॉज वन ऑफ द फेमस एम्पायर विच रोज टू ग्रेट पावर। द गोल्डन एज ऑफ विजयनगर एम्पायर वॉज ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ कृष्णदेवा राय। 1336 AD, ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ तुंगभद्रा रिवर, द विजयनगर एम्पायर वॉज फाउंडेड बाई हरिहर एंड बुक्का। हम्पी वॉज द कैपिटल ऑफ विजयनगर किंगडम। मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट रूलर ऑफ संगमा डायनेस्टी वॉज देवा राय सेकेंड। He was a great conqueror and able ruler. Industry and overseas trade flourished under him. Krishnadevaraya, the man and the king. Krishnadevaraya, the man and the king. Krishnadevaraya is regarded as greatest king of Vijayanagar Empire. Inscriptions and accounts of foreign travelers provide information about Krishnadevaraya and his rule. It is said that the king's generosity and attractive manners won over the loyalty of his subjects. He was an athlete and did regular exercise to keep fit. He was a wise statesman and administrator. Krishnadevaraya says in Amuktamalyada, a crowned king should always rule with an eye towards dharma. Vijayanagar Empire was at its zenith of glory during the rule of Krishnadevaraya. Conquest. Krishnadevaraya was a great warrior. He occupied Siva Samudram in 1510 AD, Raichur in 1512 AD, Orisha and Warangal in 1523 AD. He also occupied a large part of Deccan. He extended the empire from the Arabian Sea in the west to the Bay of Bengal in the east and River Krishna in the north to the River Kaveri in the south. Contributions. Krishnadevaraya was a good administrator. He constructed large tanks and canals for irrigation purposes. The naval power was improved for overseas trade. Krishnadevaraya constructed beautiful temples and palaces as he was a patron of art and architecture. To increase the revenue of the government, a friendly relationship was maintained with the Portuguese and Arab traders. Krishnadevaraya was himself a scholar of Telugu and Sanskrit. He was the author of great work Amuktamalyada, explaining how a king should rule. His court patronized a group of 8 scholars known as Ashtadiggajas. Administrative system. The king was the head of the empire and was assisted by a council of ministers. The empire was divided into provinces and the provinces were divided into villages. Contact between the central administrations and villages were through Mahanayakacharyas. The Krishnadevaraya followed a policy of tolerance toward everybody, whether a Christian, Jews, Moor or Heathen. Pius, a Portuguese traveler, has given a glowing account of Krishnadevaraya's personality and spoke about his efficient administration and prosperity of his kingdom. Economic conditions. Vijayanagar was a rich and prosperous empire. Textile production, mining, metalworking and perfumery industries thrived during this period. Cereals, spices, silk, cotton and other goods were exported. Elephants, horses, copper, coal and mercury were imported. Position of women and social life. Women were held in high esteem in the Vijayanagar Empire. They participated in political, social and literary life. They were trained in use of weaponry and wrestling. Women were proficient in fine arts and music. They were well educated and held high position in the court. Social life in Vijayanagar was well structured. Sati, child marriage and polygamy existed. Citizens were given religious freedom. Architecture and literature. Architecture and literature thrived under the rulers of Vijayanagar. Renowned temples built during this period were the Vitthal Swami and Hazara Ramaswamy temples. Language like Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu and Kannada were given importance and several scholars were patronized. Krishna Devarai wrote Usha Purinayam and Jamavati Kalyanam in Sanskrit and Amuktyamalyada in Telugu. Battle of Talikota. Krishna Devarai's successors were weak. A joint force of Ahmednagar, Bijapur, Golconda and Bidar fought against Vijayanagar Empire during the period of King Ramaraya in the Battle of Talikota. The battle was fought in 1565 AD. In the battle, Ramaraya was put to death by the enemy. Vijayanagar Empire was looted and destroyed to a great extent.
Bahmani Kingdom. In about 1347, Hassan, an officer of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, took the title Alauddin Bahman Shah and established the Bahmani Kingdom. He made Gulbarga his capital. Altogether, 18 Bahmani rulers ruled between 1347 to 1527. They had constantly fought against the rulers of neighboring Vijayanagar. Ahmad Shah, the ninth Bahmani ruler, won a great victory against Vijayanagar. He moved his capital to Bidar. His kingdom was, however, weakened by the conflict between two groups of nobles, those of the Deccans and those of Persian, Turkish and Arabian origins. Mahmud Gawan was an able and loyal minister of 13 Bahmani ruler who ruled from 1463 to 1482. Gawan defeated the rulers of Konkan, Orissa and Warangal. He captured Goa from Vijayanagar. This increased the Bahmani kingdom's overseas trade with Iran and Iraq. Gawan also had friendly relations with Ottoman ruler Muhammad II, who had conquered Constantinople in 1453.
Gawan reorganized the revenue system and maintained a strong army. He built a madrasa in Bidar, which gave free boarding and lodging to nearly 1,000 students and attracted scholars from as far as Iran and Iraq. In 1481, the Deccan nobles conspired against Gawan, who was of foreign origin. They had him executed on charge of disloyalty. After this, Bahmani kingdom declined steadily until it broke up around 1527. Contributions of the Bahmani kingdom. The Bahmani rulers patronized literature, music, art and architecture. They invited both Indian and foreign scholars to their courts. The Urdu language flourished under their patronage. Thus, the Deccan became a rich cultural center. The Bahmani rulers built forts, palaces, mosques, and tombs. Their architecture was influenced by Indian, Persian, Egyptian, and Turkish styles. The Jama Masjid of Gulbarga and Mahmud Gawan's Madrasa in Bidar are the most remarkable monuments of the Bahmani kingdom.
Your topics over, you read the chapter once more and do this question answer in your fair notebook. Thank you.